च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्मस्वरूपिणि अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः. टुडे द लास्ट डे ऑफ द ईयर 2015 ऑन द ईव ऑफ द ट्रांजिशन ऑफ mankind into the year 2016, we have all gathered here in this prestigious hall to hear an illuminating talk by Professor Dr. Manilal Bhoumik on the topic Our Place in the Cosmos. We shall begin the function by chanting from the Vedas by the students of our functional Sanskrit course.
दक्षिण पक्षः अयम् उत्तर शांति ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम। पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरि ओम् तत्सत् श्रीरामकृष्णार्पणमस्तु।
Professor Dr. Manilal Bhaumik, a great physicist, was born in 1931 in Bengal during the Indian independence struggle. He received his PhD in quantum physics in 1958 from the Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur, and later a Sloan Foundation Fellowship for postdoctoral work at University of California, Los Angeles. Later, he achieved international recognition and success as a co-inventor of the laser technology that made LASIK eye surgery possible. Dr. Bhaumik's current interest is in sharing with the public the astounding advances in quantum physics and cosmology and the implications in our lives, work, technology, and spiritual development. His endeavors are published in his book, Code Name God and the Cosmic Detective. His keen interest is in the research on the origin and nature of consciousness and how that knowledge can be utilized in improving the quality of our existence. Dr. Bhaumik is best known and revered internationally for his creation of the Bhaumik Educational Foundation based in Kolkata, which provides full scholarships to needy but brilliant students who wish to apply themselves to studies in science and technology. I request Revered Swami Suparnanandaji to felicitate Dr. Manilal Bhaumik. Professor at the C.V. Raman Center for Physics and Music, Jadavpur University. Now, Professor Dilip Kumar Ghosh, President of Kolkata Society for Asian Studies, will be felicitated. Dilip Kumar Ghosh to deliver the welcoming address. Thank you.
Mr. President, respected Dr. Ghosh, respected Swami Suparnanandaji Maharaj, respected Professor Dr. Mani Bhavik, ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed a pleasure and privilege for me to welcome you all to this lecture program organized by the Kolkata Society for Asian Studies in collaboration with Ramakrishna Mission Institute of Culture, Golpak, to hear Dr. Mani Bhaumik on our place in cosmos, a subject of perennial interest of the people at large and cosmologists in particular. At the outset, I take this opportunity to thank you all for kindly accepting our invitation to this program and for your gracious presence. Dr. Mani Bhaumik, our speaker of this morning, is a scholar extraordinary. To speak on Professor Bhaumik would take hours, and as the time at my disposal is short, it has been decided to show a short documentary on Professor Bhaumik immediately after this welcome address. I shall try to focus on some major aspects of his outstanding life and achievements. Dr. Bhaumik was born in a small village in the district of Midnapur. The life of Dr. Bhaumik is a classic example of the rise of a man from literally rags to riches. His humble childhood included grazing family cattle to pasture and sleeping on rags in a thatched roof mud hut. During the famine of 1942, his grandmother died of malnutrition by giving her portion of the food to him. That ultimate sacrifice left an indelible mark and impression and made him determined to climb out of the black hole of poverty. Education seemed to be the only way to get started on this struggle. So he walked barefoot to the nearest school 5 miles away from his residence. After schooling, he joined Scottish Church College as a scholar on a scholarship for BSc in physics. And at that time only, he could afford to purchase a suit. He did his MSc from Calcutta University under the great inspiration of Professor Satyendranath Bose. He did his PhD from IIT Kharagpur. After his PhD, he received Sloan Foundation Fellowship for postdoctoral studies at the University of California, Los Angeles, USA. And from then on, the immense struggle finally began to pay off. Dr. Bhaumik established himself as a lesser physicist and announced the invention of the world's first excima laser at the Denver, Colorado meeting of the American Optical Society in May 1973. This is the class of laser that would eventually eliminate glasses or contact lenses, in many cases requiring vision correction. The procedure known as corneal sculpting takes less than a minute and benefited billions of people the world over. During his 25-year career, Dr. Bhoumik published over 50 papers in professional scientific journals and is a holder of more than a dozen U.S. patents in the field of laser. Dr. Bhoumik is also a prolific writer with a facile pen and has published a number of books which have become bestsellers in America, including Codename God and The Cosmic Detective. The product of his research to find relationships between advanced science and spirituality. His book-length biography in Bengali, Munikantam, has also a wide readership in Bengal, the land of his birth. In recognition of his contribution in the field of laser research, Dr. Bhoumik received honors galore, including Fellowship of the American Physical Society, DSC, Honorary Scholar from IIT Kharagpur for Lifetime Achievement, a Chair in Theoretical Physics after him at the University of California, Los Angeles, listed in Who's Who in America, American Men and Women in Science, and the syndicated TV program, Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, and last but not the least, Padma Shri from the Government of India. His love for his roots and the realization that education is the major instrument of empowerment prompted him to set up Moni Bhoumik Educational Foundation to provide financial support to poor but meritorious students from rural Bengal, and the beneficiaries number more than 300 since 2001. Besides, Dr. Bhoumik has embarked on an ambitious mission to produce the next Nobel laureate from India in the next 10 years. And with that objective in view, he acquired 15 acres of land and would contribute $150 million plus his personal wealth to set up in collaboration with IIT Kharagpur, his alma mater, the Kolkata campus, to undertake groundbreaking research in bioinformation and energy science in India. He is also setting up a team of mentors and professors in their established fields from universities like University of California, Los Angeles, and California Institute of Technology to spend their summer and winter breaks in the IIT Kolkata campus and work with the young scientists and to network the groundbreaking discoveries with the eminent scientific circles abroad. Dr. Bhoumik is also currently focusing on dissemination of the professional but rather esoteric knowledge recently uncovered by quantum physicists. The goal of complementing spirituality. With that end in view, Dr. Bhoumik established Cosmogenics Incorporated, a U.S. educational foundation. Dr. Bhoumik recently developed a TV cartoon series entitled Captain Cosmos for bringing the latest in quantum physics to children through entertainment, which fetched him an award from the Cannes Film Festival. Before I conclude, I take this opportunity to request my esteemed friend Dr. Bhoumik to kindly release the maiden issue of the bilingual journal of the Kolkata Society for Asian Studies. Our endeavor is to make this journal of international standard dedicated to the development of all branches of social sciences with special reference to Asian studies. With these words, once again, I welcome you all, and particularly Dr. Moni Bhoumik, the international icon of Indian origin. Thank you.
We will now the Journal of Calcutta Society for Asian Studies to be released. It is volume 1, documentary on Professor Dr. Moninal Bhoumik and his works.
Received, and he is making a tremendous difference in their young lives. And I himself has become a beloved man in his native land. He is taking his love of science to the children of the world by creating a cartoon series for television that gets kids interested in science in a way that entertains them visually.
Beware, villains who violate the laws of nature!
It's gravity, Ray. Something's happening to us.
This is the big daddy of all natural law violations.
I've had the great pleasure to interview some incredible celebrities, many from the literary world. So many amazing authors, so many great books. One that I just read is a must-read. It's called Codename God, and is written by a fascinating man, Dr. Manny Valmik.
As Einstein said, I'm quoting in that book, a famous quote, that science without religion is lame, and religion without science is blind. Consciousness is beyond energy. Consciousness can actually affect energy, and as you know, consciousness can heal. Science can explain why you feel happy. Science can prevent us from going down a thorny path by showing that something that we have thought about is not right. The blueprint of everything that happens in this universe is encoded in space itself. Now, why can you not see it? Well, you cannot see gravity. You cannot touch gravity. Mind and matter are related. And that probably is the basis of true spirituality. I was able to be a volunteer in Gandhi's camp when he came to our area. I was following him like a little duckling around and was privileged to sit by his side when he was giving talks to almost a couple of million people come every afternoon to hear him.
Dr. Manny Valmik's message has captured the hearts and minds of notables from all walks of life. From the literary world, here's what some authors have to say. Sidney Sheldon, best-selling author, says, "This book may change your life." Fritjof Capra, author of the international bestseller, The Tao of Physics, says, "The author's personal odyssey is eloquently told and makes for fascinating reading." Paula Darcy, author of Sacred Threshold and A New Set of Eyes, says, "Manny Valmik offers us scientific genius in order to present a compelling new argument for mysticism and faith." And Laura, Mrs. Aldous Huxley, founder of Children, Our Ultimate Investment, says, "The merging of matter and spirit, as presented in this book, might facilitate a much-needed evolutionary step forward in our capacity to love and be fair." Life came full circle on November 15, 2005, at the Regent Beverly Wilshire Hotel in Beverly Hills, California. Celebrities from all around the globe gathered to pay tribute to Dr. Manny Valmik as he received the coveted Gandhi Award. Stars included Angie Dickinson, star of TV's Policewoman, Peter Falk, star of Columbo, legendary film stars Barbara Rush and Betty Garrett, and Sean Taub, one of the stars of Crash, which won the Oscar this year for Best Film. This memorable evening was hosted by Sir Ben Kingsley, who received the Academy Award for Best Actor for his portrayal of Gandhi. Sir Ben was so moved by Codename God, he recorded the foreword to the audio version of the book. Here's what the legendary actor had to say about Dr. Valmik.
I think words like oneness and spirituality are almost impossible for us to define, but where I think Dr. Manny makes these philosophical ideas tangible is through example. A man who has set such a great example to his community and to us through the education of young people, through his intelligence and generosity, is Dr. Manny. When you see young people receiving their bursaries, their grants, their money, their certificates of education, young people who otherwise would have had nothing, Dr. Manny is empowering these children. And if after maybe 10, 15 years, when they're fully educated and fully realized, maybe out of 1,000 of them, there is maybe one Che Guevara, one Mahatma Gandhi, out of 1,000 of them, Dr. Manny, you have done more than we can ever thank you for, because you would have changed the face of the world.
You know, when I was growing up as a child, there was a Sanskrit word we heard, Aham Brahmasmi, means I am part of God. And this is something Now science is showing that we are really part of this whole scenario. And some skeptics ask me, well, did God create man or man create a God? So I answer them with a similar question back. Is your mind separate from your body? Or does it make you, the whole you? So in reality, man and creator are comprised one wholeness that we are all part of. And this is something that we really need to get into our consciousness, take root and get it under our belt so that we'll know how to live in the age of science with spirituality. Because spirituality really is an inside job. Thank you.
The global press was there and wrote enthusiastically about this memorable night. This year, the University of California just announced an international award in the name of Dr. Mamie Baumick. The Mamie Baumick Award has been set up at the Norman Cousins Center for Psychoneuroimmunology at UCLA to advance understanding of the conscious mind's role in healing. Codename God has become so popular, it debuted in the top 10 on the distinguished LA Times bestseller list. Dr. Mamie Baumick, laser whiz who helped lay the foundation for 15 million people having LASIK eye surgery, was the keynote speaker this year at the annual Indian Heritage Awards. Physicist, philanthropist, author, and without a doubt, a connoisseur of life.
I now request Revered Swami Sukarnanda Ji Maharaj, Secretary of Ramakrishna Mission Institute of Culture, to deliver the inaugural address.
Om Jamani Sharadam Devi Giramo Krishna Mujagat Guru. So in this serene atmosphere, since last date of the year, we are here to listen to a beautiful man, a man who has been spending his life all by himself, having no family, no friend, no wife, no son, no daughter, nothing, but ready to bequeath everything for the nation, for the world citizens. So wonderful man indeed. We congratulate him, we welcome him, Dr. Mani Bhavik. We have just viewed the way he has been honored, everybody, as President of USA. How his books have been lauded, have been praised by so many renowned authors. And when I was just felicitating him with a bouquet, he whispered to me, "I am honored, I am honored." Yes, Dr. Baumick, you are not honored as such. We are honored. When you spoke those beautiful words, "I am honored," I felt not that we are honored. We are humbled. Your humility has become so contagious. We are humble. In honoring you, we are honored, and more than that, we are humbled. True humility. We have yet to see in many, and you are one among these very few persons. Very few persons. What is all like you have heard, you have seen? I'm not going to repeat it. But I say only one sentence, one, say half of your hearts. By the poet Satyendranath Dutt. Amra gharer cheler chokhe dekhechi bishwabhuper chhaya. Our very own lad of our house. In the very eyes of that lad, we have seen the shadow of this, of becoming the emperor of the world. He is now really become the emperor. Not that emperor. Emperor of our hearts. Of the world. He is dealing with spirit. Spirit is all powerful. Spirit is called the real empire in humanity. Spirit. That alone is true. And everything else is anatman, false. Brahma satyam jagat mithya. That is the great utterance. And he has been trying establish that fact from the point of view of science. So in the area of causation, we have always the finite. The causation makes everything subject to death and birth. Beyond causation is unborn, within causation is death and birth, finite. Within the bounds of time, everything is subject to change, but beyond time it is unchanged. Similarly, within space, space makes everything subject to division. What cannot exist in the absence of space? Division. So beyond space is undivided, within space is divided. So long, scientists have been trying to find out the reality within the bounds of space, time and position. And that's why they could not find it. Because that absolute lies beyond space, causation, time. They're undivided, unborn, and unchanged. So no physical entity can have any grasp of it. Cannot. Truth lies beyond this phenomenal world. But see, we have been searching for that within this boundary, because we cannot go beyond that. That is our lacuna. That is our weakness. A small particle. You can go on dividing it, breaking it successively, 200 times, 300 times. Yes, atoms have been divided that way. Only to find that this big universe does not exist in space. Then where it has gone? It has gone to the inquirer, the analyst himself. It has first gone to his mind. Mind is also matter. And it has gone beyond mind. It has become one with spirit. The spirit is within us. We carry it within. It is limited. Sorry, it is unlimited, but comfort, but curiously enough, it resides within the finite body. How can it be? In the finite is infinite. How could it be? So we all know the concept of infinite. Infinite is within the finite body. It is not your usual physics or usual mathematics. এক শ্রেণী কোটি থেকে পাঁচ শ্রেণী দূর ধরে ম্যাথামেটিক্যালি ইট ইজ ফলস ইট ক্যানট বি বাট ইয়েস এট দ্য ফাইনাইট বডি উই হ্যাভ ইনফিনিট ইজ রিসাইডিং দেয়ার ইয়েস এক শ্রেণী কোটিতে হাজার হাজার কেজি দূর ধরবে That is not an impossibility. And you have heard this Tegosan, Sima Ramaje Asimtuni. This is Sima Vadi Asimtuni. That has to be established. Not by referring to the facts and figures in the laboratory, because it cannot be proved in the laboratory. It has to be proved through meditation, inwardly. That's it. So we are going to have a very nice discussion, nice elocution from Professor Moni Bhoumik. Moni Kanchan, he has written a book. He is Moni, naturally the greatest, the most valuable diamond. He is now sitting on the heap of Kanchan, gold. How? Moni Kanchan. Kanchan is gold. How? By the invention of that lesser theory. But for him, we would have been all blind. Each and every person requiring an eye operation will have to stand before him with folded hands. Yes, because of you, we have got this opportunity. He is that person. We all owe to him. We are all indebted to this great man. And that fetched him being fortune. A series of patents he has taken. And with that money, because he has no family to fall back up, to leave behind. Because of that, his only concern are his countrymen. But he has now become a world citizen. The world has loved. Citizens of the world. Dr. Bhoumik, we are really proud of you. And we are honored and humbled in, say, not only felicitating you, in having you in our midst. Whatever you will be telling would be encouraging us. Our own boy has become a crowning success, has attained a crowning success. Yet he is now wearing the crown of the world. How much pride we have in us because of you, because of you. You are yet to become a household name in Bengal, I tell you. But you very soon you would be. Your great predecessor like Vidyasagar, you would be remembered by all of us one day. Here is a man. Here was a man in Vrindavan. Who did a lot for us. For the world itself. And still he's so humble. So humble. So I have not thought of speaking all these things in the beginning. I got the, say, biodata and I wanted to read it out, but Professor Dilip Ghosh did that. So I welcome him also. And Dr. Deepak Ghosh, a good friend of ours, the professor of physics in the University of Jadavpur, now retired, holding emeritus status there, is to preside. I welcome him. And I welcome you all, well-meaning audience present before me, not to miss even a word that would fall from the dear lips of Dr. Bhoumik Nost.
We will now hear Professor Dr. Manilal Bhoumik speak on our place in the cosmos.